Praise the Lord. As identified in this passage of scripture, there was a severe famine going on. It was a period when there were no longer plenty, things were no longer plentiful. But there was a scarcity. There was war, there was battle, there was confusion. There was a state of chaos. But we come right down to the conclusion of the matter. Habakkuk, in coming to the conclusion of the matter, he, from this difficult, dismal situation, he pulled out a positive. In other words, he is saying, I am not going to look at circumstances, I'm not going to look at situations, but I'm going to look to my God,
Amen.
Who is able to do far exceedingly and abundantly more than we can ask, think, or deserve. So hear what he says in the 17th verse. Although the fig tree should not blossom, neither shall there be fruit in the vine, and the labor of the olive shall fail, and the field shall yield no meat, and the flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stall. And when we analyze all of those phrases in that verse, it tells us of a very bleak picture. Imagine, no figs on the tree, meaning the fruit are not there to be eaten. Not only that, but no blossoms, meaning that there is no hope for anything quite soon. No blossom. Because the blossom signals that the fruit is getting ready to develop, and then there will soon be fruit to be harvested. But there ain't a fruit on the tree, not a blossom. He said, neither shall there be any fruit on the vine. The trees ain't bearing, the vines ain't bearing. And he moved from the vegetation and he goes to the animals. Hallelujah. He said, and the labor of the olive shall fail. Working with the olive will make no sense because there's no production. And the field shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold. And there shall be no herd in the stall. There shall be no flock. Neither shall there be none in the field, neither shall there be any in the stall. Everything is barren. A time of barren. A time of desolation. And when we reflect at the time in which we are living in, we need to understand that it is a gradual process that is taking us to a point of scarcity. Things that were in abundance are no longer in abundance the way they were before. But thank God to those of us who can still get into the ground and plant something. Because if you will remember, those who will have had the experience of history, at the time of war, the ships were not able to travel, and therefore there was a great scarcity where food was concerned. Right now, there is a restriction on travel. There is a restriction on transportation of cargo. Yes, it has not reached the point that it was before. But let us focus ourselves and focus on the times and focus on our God and be creative. We have to be creative. Look at means and methods of preserving what we have, stretching what we have, and preparing for the time in which we live. These are the time. Habakkuk, in analyzing the situation and the gravity of the situation, he came to a conclusion that we also today at Talking About can come to. Praise the Lord. Although all of these things are happening and this is the time in which we are living in, our attitude can be one of thanksgiving. Our attitude can be one of giving God the glory and the praise. Somebody says little is much when God is in. Not only that, but where there is that spirit of contentment, that spirit of contentment helps us to overcome many challenges.
Amen.
If there was one that was sick and you visit them in the hospital, and you compare that one that is content, every time you go, I'm thankful, contented, happy, contented, You know, whatever they lack, and that's the person's attitude, mm-hmm. along with the other person that is always on the same situation. Both persons lost a leg in the process, both of them in the same hospital and everything. But one is contented and the other one is vexed at the work. After a while, the one who is contented might nurse look all of her head because she will find a lot of those practical situations in dealing with. The patient that is contented, the patient that exercises and all that thing, well, you know, the Lord is working on his purpose, seeing all things work together for good, that is the patient that will get better and get better quickly. Because with that spirit of contentment, amen. They are able to experience God's bountiful blessings upon it. Only last night I heard a sermon being preached. And the preacher said something like that, looking at the word broken. He said, it is only when we are broken that we are able to experience the manifold blessings of Almighty God.
Amen.
And he used that illustration with the feeding of the feeding of the 5,000. There were two small fish and 5 barley loaves. Mm-hmm. And then what happened? At the breaking of the bread, mm-hmm. when the bread were broken and distributed, that is when the abundant miracle took place.
Yes.
Over 5,000 were blessed. Yes. As a result of that, and they had the fragments that left over.
Yes.
So brother, when we go through life experiences that brings us to that point of brokenness, that brings us to that point of where we recognize, well, I need God now because only God can bring me out of that situation, and we totally and completely release ourselves to him, that is the point at which we come back. That is the point at which God then is able to place us on a new footing, move us from one level to another.
Yeah.
And we find ourselves moving towards the mountaintop. We move towards the mountaintop, one level, another level, and each time we are moving on up, we are moving on up. And today that is what God wants to do for us.
Yeah.
He wants to move us from one level to the other. But as he moves us, or as we move with him, we have to recognize that he is in control. He is working his purpose over. So what Habakkuk said, he said, look, yet will I rejoice. All of these things that are going on around me will not impact negatively upon me because I'm looking to the Creator. My trust, my faith, and my confidence.